But what are we gonna talk? All right, so hello YouTube, and today, me and my friend, I have a little guest here. We wanna go by the friend.
Dre.
Okay, I have a friend named Dre here. Basically, today we're gonna be talking about album of the year so far, because we know there's some people who haven't dropped their albums yet, and we're still waiting on them. Like Lil Uzi, for example. I still think it's gonna be album of the year, but okay, so. First, I'm gonna start off saying my top three albums, I guess. I'm gonna say my top three albums. So, I'm not sure if you guys know, but you know, my top three favorite rappers are like Kendrick Lamar, J. Cole, and Chance the Rapper. Although Chance the Rapper is making me mad right now because he's not dropping any music. But anywho, I say at number one spot, I put KOD just based on the fact that I think J. Cole is a really good, great rapper, and also. He's like he had a topic.
My fault.
I know, right? He got a he stuck to a topic throughout the whole album, and every single song in there was fire. At least in my opinion, you know. And then, you know, like the production was really good. You know, it's pretty good. And also, just because J. Cole is just a freaking guy. Now next, I'm gonna have to say, see, y'all gonna be mad. I probably don't like Drake like that. Like I don't like Drake like that. So I'm gonna put. I put Astroworld.
Find the bio.
Astroworld. There were some songs in there I didn't like, but like overall it was pretty good. It had some slaps. Slaps. Is that cringy, DeAndre? Oh, freak.
I'm gonna cut that out. A little bit.
Alright.
It's alright.
Cut that out. Yeah, that was a little cringy. What else? I don't even know. It was all right. It was good. And not a lot of great albums came out this year. And actually, before, right when I was thinking of this idea for the video, I forgot that Kendrick Lamar came out with an album. Technically, the Black Panther album. And that one was pretty good. I'm not gonna lie. So I'm gonna put that at number three. That's Drake when I build this list. Okay. Now I'm sure for my friend over here, I don't think he gonna have Drake on the list as well. But yeah, just because that album had, I don't know if you count that as like a really like a Kendrick Lamar album because he wasn't on all the songs. Well, he was in all the songs, but barely. But it was all right. He was all right. And if I had to put like some honorable mentions, I'd probably put Young Thug and SOB XRBE. They count with the album. That was actually, that joint was actually all right.
Wait, which one?
You know,
the
new
album.
I forget. It was like the newest one. It came out this year. Yeah, it came out this year. Yeah.
I don't know, did it?
Pretty sure it did.
I even know they dropped the album.
For real?
Oh,
I'm gonna listen to that. But yeah, I put that on the list, and I guess I put Drake on the list. But okay, I'm on the back steps. Got her. But yeah, that's it right now. If I think of something else, I'll come up. I'll say something, but my friend Dre over here is going to give you guys his top three. But you can go ahead, DeAndre.
So, for me, my top three, I'm a big fan of like underground artists, I guess. Like, all my favorite rappers are like not mainstream at all. Like, my favorite rapper is like Chief Keef and like Lil Wayne. Like, they're not mainstream at all. But Keef did come out with an album this year that was like. Noticeable, I guess, like he came out with like a little mixtape, but it wasn't that good. I'm not gonna lie. But anyway, so my top three albums of this year, I would have to say.
Yo, he back here, man. That was a terrible number.
Where is he?
In the vault. Be right. Or he probably ran around. Right there. Let's go. Yo, that was a terrible gunfight. I'm scared to put that in, but go ahead.
That's tough. I'm glad you let me know he was there, cause I was gonna listen to love.
Yeah.
Dang, that figure will fucking help me too.
Facts.
But, alright, so my number one, I would have to say, would be, as of right now, I would say Life's a Trip.
Life's a Trip is up there. No, that's number three. Life's a Trip is number three. I forgot all about that. Oh my
big
god.
Big facts.
Yes, Life's a Trip
big
is actually. When Jupiter dropped Romeo and Juliet, that was like his first song that I heard. I did not like it, but over time, I started liking it more and more, but.
Okay, so Jimmy Red is like, as of right now, he's like top five in my opinion. Like my top five favorite rapper. So I've been
getting
looking
up,
for
he getting
a
up a bomb right now. He getting close.
Facts. So he was dropping like little snippets like "License Trip, License Trip." He was like the track was like almost 30 songs long. Mm-hmm. He had everybody like hyping it up. It was only it was only 14 songs. So I was a little disappointed. But like overall, that in my opinion, right now, like that is a banger. Like he did like a lot of he finished a lot of songs. Like he previewed "Missing My Idols." He made that into like a full song, and that was a banger. He put UK on the album, that was a banger. So like, in my opinion, that got number one out there right now. Number two for me, I would have to go with he's more of like an underground artist. But in my opinion, I'm going with Young Nudy, Slumball 3, in my opinion, is fire. Like you can, if you listen to each album, like Slumball 1, then listen to Slumball 2, then listen to Slumball 3, you see how much he progresses as an artist. Like, it was fire to me.
Yeah, I don't like a lot of underground rappers, and I could definitely say that he's a pretty good one.
And my number three would have to be Juice WRLD, Goodbye and Good Riddance. That album was so fire. Every song on there was bigger to me. Every song. Like, a lot of people was, All Girls Are the Same, or Lucid Dreams are the best two songs on the album. In my opinion, I think Candles and Lean With Me was the best song on the album. Like, it's fire. Like, yeah. Juice WRLD is like, multi-talented. Like, he can sing, he can, like, actually rap when he really wants to. Like, he had, like, good features on the album. Like, he's good. He's a good artist, in my opinion. Make their way mainstream. Like, Trippie Redd isn't fully mainstream yet, but, like, more people are, like, starting to know him. This album is, like, it's like putting his foot in the door, I guess you could say. Like, he sold more than 6ix9ine first week. He sold, like, 72K first week. He got 100 million streams on Spotify. Like, he's doing numbers right now. Like, I know at least half the songs that I'm gonna go platinum. I know they are. Like, UK is gonna go platinum. If it didn't already,
you need to locate the biohazard.
Taking a walk.
UKA, Missing My Idols. And
maybe Shake It Up. Maybe that.
Oh, yeah. Like, 39 yeah. Demo. If that. Oh, that already went platinum.
That already went platinum, yeah.
But that's what I think. And Young Nudy, I feel like if he consistently drops more music and like consistently like gets better and better, he's gonna be able to blow up. Cause I'm not saying like all rappers blow up because of like family members, but he's related to 21 Savage. Everybody knows 21 Savage is. Everybody likes his music. Like not everybody, but a lot of people like his music, whatever. So if they keep saying like, oh yeah, 21 Savage cousin coming out with a banger, like he's gonna consistently get more and more views. Like he has a concert in Jersey. Like the next couple of weeks, and I think I'm gonna go to that and see how that joint is.
Speaking of a concert, so this is concert in Philly called Made in America, right? And this year, it's gonna be fire. They got everybody going. They got like Meek Mill, 6ix9ine, Nicki Minaj. I forget who else they got, but that joint gonna be fire.
Yeah, that's tough. Speaking of Philly rappers, I'm gonna have to shout out Core in that joint too. Core, I was listening to his album. His little mixtape EP, I guess you could say, came out the other day. I listened to it last night. Core is continually getting better and better. And he went on Flex, the freestyle. That freestyle on Flex was fire. He just like he's progressively getting better in my opinion.
Yeah, I really don't like Core like that. So I really don't listen. I mean, there's like only one song I like. I don't know what it's called. But here's a. I think that's about it. I think we covered everything. I don't think we missed anybody. For real. So,
was there any albums that disappointed you or that you didn't like at all?
That disappointed me? I'm gonna say.
Yeah.
Ooh, disappointed me. Well, this is. Yes, actually, there's one person. So, I don't know. You know who Jaden Smith is? Will Smith's son, right? You know, he raps.
Yeah.
Headshot.
Yeah.
He raps now. So he came out with this, he had an album called Sire. But then he's gonna drop like a part two to it. And it's called like Sire Electric Album. And it was just like he sung on the album before and I liked it, but this time it was just like the It was like the same song continuing out through the album, but just like adding like more stuff. And I did not like I didn't like it at all. Like, I was so hyped because I went on, like, I follow him and Spotify sent notifications saying Janet Smith just dropped some new music. So I was like, I'm lit. I started listening to it. And I'm like, is he going to stop, like, singing? Like, what the heck? Start rapping? Because he can actually rap, I think, in my opinion. But he didn't. And I bet him, man. So I think that's his point. Anybody for you?
Besides the Maritime 11? Nice. Disappointed me?
Yeah.
No, but artists that like he, I don't think he, like a lot of people hate on him a lot. I think maybe a young boy like the Reloaded joint, like his it's a Death Call My Name Reloaded. Yeah. I know it wasn't like really like a new album because it was Reloaded. It was like the same song. He just added a couple more songs. But I feel as though like the song that he added and the features that he had on it. Why did he keep going Office? Can we go Lockers, please?
Right.
The songs that he had on it, that he added, like I feel like I feel like it was better. Like he was featuring Lil Uzi on it. That song was pretty good. Remember, let me get the album now real quick. Let me see. Overdose was good. Okay, from song 1 through 6, no, 1 through 8 actually, all good. Now once you get to like 9 through like 15, those are like the songs that's kind of iffy, I guess. But then song 16 with Lil Uzi, that was good. Then 18, 19, and 20 were good. Through the Storm, Genie, Love Is Poison. So I like, that album was pretty good, in my opinion. But I think if he would like, have me like an entirely new album, it probably would have did better than it did.
Yeah. And Culture 3, like it got a lot of bangers on there. I forgot they came out this year. Culture 3 had a lot of bangers, but it just like, it wasn't, it was just like the Migos. Like, it's like, it wasn't nothing crazy. It was just.
Yeah.
Like,
I think
right now. I mean, go ahead. Say what you got.
I mean, I was just looking at Apple Music at the all the albums, like the top albums right now. Actual is number 1. Slam Language just came out and it's number 3.
Yeah.
And I feel as though Slam Language might actually pass it. I don't know why, but I feel like it was so hyped up. I like it. He got a lot of features, good features on there too, so the Edge Road, but yeah, and Juice WRLD is still number seven, like he didn't go down, he's still pretty high up, and so is Top 10 at least, and I'm surprised that Lexa Tripp passed Scorpio for Drake, and a lot of people don't really listen to Tripp, right, like that, but for him to pass Drake and album sales on Apple Music is pretty good, and he had a Spotify, so I mean he's doing what he's doing right now. That's a lot of that.
Alright. So I think that's about it. I think we cut everything. So I said KOD would probably win album of the year. And you said, who did you say?
Yeah, probably. I said
Lexa Tripp. Lexa Tripp, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Alright, so if you guys have any different suggestions, put them in the comments. And please, y'all be sitting there. I don't ever watch my videos. I'm not even gonna lie to you. I got 95 subscribers and I get like 13 views. Like, why is that even a thing? Why is that a thing, yeah?
Right.
I better get a whole bunch of likes. And I'll put your YouTube channel in the description, right? I got you. I'm gonna put your YouTube channel in the description.
Alright, but. I downed them. My boy, Joe. I ain't even sure. I downed them and killed them. My fault.
Alright, well, I think that's about it. So, like and subscribe.
Yeah.